Revisiting the magic of Wicked with Kristin Chenoweth and Joel Crump.
If you don't mind, I'm going to pull out my theater piece of Wicked memorabilia.
Okay.
When I saw Wicked back in 2018, I got my program book. And, you know, I was looking back at this program book, and I came to this page, and it just reminded me how you are Glinda. And Glinda is you, and when I think of you, Kristin, I think of someone that's, you know, lighthearted and fun and bubbly, and all of that is Glinda. So, how did you know, what was it like creating this role? And knowing that this role was truly created for you?
Luckily, I was given a lot of freedom to play through and create her. And even, dare I say, you know, come up with some of the lines. They were so gracious in that learning possibilities for me. They invited me to add as much of me and all of it as I wanted to, and also encouraged me to go really deep in Act Two. You know, there's a point where Glinda really sends Marble off to prison.
Yeah.
And everybody thinks, oh, singing popular or doing such and such was your favorite part. Sending her off to prison, and I loved me by Carol Shelley, God bless you, Carol. I loved her so much, but I loved letting Glinda have revenge. You know, she starts to become what we know of as Glinda the Good, but it's always for me, Act Two, what makes Glinda Glinda. It's the journey. You know, it's not one note character. She starts out this way, and thinking about it, she gets her heart broken. She loses her best friend. She forgives her best friend.
Yes.
And sends her teacher on to prison and takes over.
And takes over.
Yeah.
And I feel like Glinda has the best journey. Okay. You talk about it right there. And I wanted to know, is there a specific moment or like choice that you and the Wicked team created that will stick for you forever, aside from throwing Madame Marvel in jail?
Well, a very special moment, and one that every actor and singer is very grateful for, is when Stephen Schwartz said, I'm going to write you a song for the top of Act Two. And when I first heard it, it's actually switches time signatures. It's actually very tricky, a lot trickier than people know.
Yeah.
But when I first heard it, I thought, oh, I can even be happier. It's the saddest song on the show.
It is.
Because she's having to cover up so much, and Fiero's over it. You know, he leaves. And then she has to, she sings, is there a bridge you crossed, you didn't cross, it, you know, that whole line.
Yeah.
Which really, really, to me, not only is it my personal favorite that I get to do on the show, everybody thinks it's awkward, but for character reasons, the real switch and the shift comes there.
And that's when Glinda's becoming a woman.
That's right. Amen. That's, you're right. She's not just the little princess anymore that tries on all her shoes and does her makeup. She gets the rug pulled out from underneath her. And dare I say that as humans, that's when we learn the most. You know, you could love the rainbow.
Yeah.
She starts to feel the rain.
I hate to go off script, but I want to know, in these moments in Wicked, did you feel yourself stepping into true womanhood?
Yeah. I had never played, you know, on Broadway, I had not played a real leading lady. I had played a fine girl, which I'm on the Tony for, and I played some very fun singer-dancer characters. But to watch someone become, to feel someone become a young student to the boss,
yeah.
I could feel it happening for me.
Yeah.
Personally.